Welcome to the narrowboat that James built. Hope you're all very well. Thanks for watching and for continuing to support me in this project. Today the plan was to get the flooring down and to finish doing the battens, which I did most of last night, which went down pretty well. So I finish a bit of that in the bow today and then get the flooring down, but that really is dependent on the welding being done. So we'll see what happens there. There's a bit of clankering happening outside, so who knows, that might be them. Anyway, I'll keep you posted as to how things are, and I'll also show you about the welding I need being done at the bow and what to do with the water tank. So I've had some breakthroughs there. So I'm in the bow, and I want to explain about the welds that need to be done. So this bay, if I move out of the way, I'll show you. This bay is typical of all the other bays in the boat. So it's 7 foot long, obviously 6 foot wide. And I'm going to be running my floor joists along these battens here. And at the end, and at each end, run them that way. So these are all fine, they support all the way along, but there's no support here at right at the edge. And what's going to happen is when the batten goes in, so what will happen is when the batten goes in, there's too much flex, that's too much of a bridge gap at 7 foot. So what I'm going to do is I managed to source some angle iron. So this is 3 mil thick angle iron, and we'll cut it at 23 centimeters, so 230 mil intervals, and then get them welded. Paul will do that. Weld it from and make a brace going across here at 700 mil intervals. So they're 210 centimeters long. So basically every 70, there'll be a brace. And that'll support the furthermost edges of the bays. So that's one reason why I bought the angle, angle iron. And now I'm right at the front of the bow. The other reason why I bought the angle iron is because this area here is where the water tank's going to be. And what they had before is some kind of thick, I think it was 4x2, resting on the whole floor to create like a tray for the water tank to sit in. And I think it's a 450 litre tank. And it's, what's it, a kilo per litre for water. So 450 kilos when that thing's full. That's damn heavy. And if it was on timber down here, this is a wet area. So granted, it shouldn't be wet, but it's moist and damp and cold. So that timber over time is going to degrade, and with 450 kilos support being supported on it, that is a recipe for disaster, and fixing that is not going to be easy. So what I've decided to do is, speaking to Paul, I went out yesterday to rugby and got myself some sheets, or some lengths, shall I say, of angle iron. So that's 50 mil in width and 3 mil thick. And that is going to be braced. I'll do three of them. And that is going to create it's just going to go like that. And there'll be three of them. And it'll be welded onto this brace here, and welded onto this brace here. And that will just provide some support that I can then attach some battens to, and hold it all in place nicely. So that'll be my plan, and obviously the water tank will be hidden. But I've got to just finish off the battening in this area of the hull. Area of the bow. Now I'm not going to batten from here upwards, so right at the bow, because there's no need. It's not going to be lined. It's just going to keep the insulation as it is. There's no need to line it there. It's all going to be hidden, and it's going to contain the water tank. So the more insulation there is, the better. So that's the plan there. So the battening has been finished below the gunwales, all the way down the boat on the port side, and again down here on the starboard side. So that is a job I can tick off the list. And the plan for this afternoon and this evening is to batten the floors. So let me show you what I'm talking about here in the bow. So there's a few different ways of doing this, but this is the way I'm choosing to do it. The idea is to take as much bounce out of the floor as possible and to create the most level surface that you can. The problem I've got is that this middle bar here is higher than all the other bars, which really doesn't help. So I'm going to have to get a slightly narrower, thinner part piece of timber to go on here by a couple of mil. So these ones down here, not that they're the finished pieces, obviously they're just test pieces, but these pieces here are 25 mil thick, so 2x1's 25 mil thick. This is also going to be a 2x1, but a 22 mil thick pier 2x1, and that will level off nicely, and that's pretty much the same throughout the boat, that setup. So that's kind of what I'm facing. So I can put on some of the boards today. I'm not going to get the welding being done today. That's most likely going to happen tomorrow. So, and that is hopefully going to be the welding across here, which is going to go up to that bracket there. And another one through the middle, and another one there, another angle go up there. And that can rest the water tank on there. The reason I haven't done the timber battens down here is because you're not going to be able to see any of that. That's going to be housing the water tank. So from there, see if I can get the angle. Yeah, so from there to the front hatch is 4 foot, which is enough for the water tank to fit in, which means that it's on its kind of lowest height. So it's only actually going to come up to about here, which means I can have a kind of, what I'm thinking, what I'm envisaging is a kind of broad seat or bench, kind of quite high up, maybe around this kind of height, on top of the water tank, so the kids can sit out and look at through, and as we're going along, it'd be a nice viewing platform, viewing place to sit as we're going along. But also just to chill out, and if I can get the width right, it could even turn into another berth for one of the little ones. So yeah, this is the plan for this afternoon, is to do the batten. So I'm about to go to the timber yard before they close, and I'll do some of that this afternoon and some of that this evening, and let you know how we get in on the next update. But for the time being, now the battening's done, if I've got enough drill bits to get through this stuff, then everything will be cushy. And this bit is for Mark, one of viewers who wanted to see the engine. I'm afraid I can't get it started for you, Mark, but this is her. It's a Lister SL2, air-cooled. So the air comes in from this big kind of gaping vent here at the front. I wonder if I can show you there. There we go. So the air comes in, is sucked in from there through a big fan, and so that cools the engine. To be honest, there's not a vast amount I can really show you or tell you about, because there's not much I know. That's clearly the exhaust running out there. That box there is the weed hatch, so that needs a gasket being put on it, so it's nice and watertight. That there should be the prop shaft leading out through the stern gland. And as you see, I've got a hole there at the moment, so I'm going to be having the stern gland replaced with a Vetus non-drip version. This part here, this big is the big fan, and that's what spins around and sucks in all the air, and it's absolutely covered in bloody spray foam. Here is the alternator, and I've got a spare reel on there, so I can put another alternator on and put another belt on there, and that second alternator can charge the leisure batteries, which I'm guessing will probably sit on that shelf there. There's a name for that shelf, I can't remember what it is, someone's gonna mention it. But I haven't really worked out anything of what I'm doing down here yet, to be honest, because as soon as you walk through, you see the engine. So I need to obviously put some kind of shield on that. There will be a top, you know, the deck will obviously be covering that. I'm really tempted to have a glass engine well, but that's probably something you do if you had a pretty engine, whereas that one is, well, they said it was recently refurbished, but and I've seen it start up. That's on one of the early videos, I think maybe the first video that's on, so if you did want to see it start up and make the noise mark, then by all means look at one of those earlier ones. I think, as I said, it's video one, but yeah, that's it for the time being. So I'll post another one later on tonight, show you the progress with the floors, if there is any. Hopefully there is, there has been some. In the meantime, hope you're all well, take care, stay safe. Bye-bye.